interested in, you know, enlisting my services. And I guess seeing how my engine would stack up in that kind of form.
It would be really easy to get super cocky, I think. How have you managed to avoid that?
Well, again, it's just bikes. You know, we're just riding bikes in circles at the end of the day. You know, we might be doing a little faster than everyone else at these events. But what I love about gravel racing is it's actually probably harder to be, you know, the average man or woman with a full-time job shows up, they do the same distance, you know, on a fraction of the training, and their experience is probably, easy to say, more challenging than what we do. We're tuned for this, we're trained for this, we literally work for this. If I'm not mistaken, I think it was called Texas Chainring Massacre, and it was north of Dallas in January, bitter cold day, and Lance Armstrong.
Yeah, that was where Lance did.
Yeah,
I remember that.
He showed up to the race, and it was, I think I attacked mile 5 or something, and soloed for 30 miles.
On brand, Colin.
Right, yeah.
On brand.
Yeah, to go to pretty much a kindergarten through 12th grade liberal arts school, I guess. Kindergarten all the way through elementary, and then middle school and high school, where they expose you to an extremely diverse array of different studies to kind of just expose you to all of these different disciplines and give you let you pick your own way and kind of what you at least you have a sample set of everything, all of the different disciplines, so you can kind of specialize later on in life. I'm more curious hearing about the new landscape of professional women's road racing from kind of the younger folks in that world, and just getting that perspective, because it's a parallel to what we do, but it's, you know, we really don't have much insight into it, and like just figuring out what their experience is like, you know. Yeah, it's kind of just how you tune a motor, right? Whether you want, you know, higher horsepower or whether it's just kind of a long, steady output. You can approach it, hyper-analytically and deduce, you know, exactly how to do it, but, or you can just do it and kind of just synthesize it through, you know, the similar effort and just kind of mimic the effort that you think you're going to, you know, kind of simulate a race effort and train that way. I always say train like you race. So whether that's, you know, if you like, you know, for even like a group ride, like, shit, I think race rides are really, really beneficial where everyone's really just out there kind of going as hard as they can, because it prepares you for that kind of race stuff.